Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the 94th Strawberry Festival at the Deane Winthrop House down here in Shirley Street. We're here actually a little bit of the, you could say, the calm before the storm. We're about a half hour before they start serving, and we thought you would be the most some of the beautiful surroundings down here before it's covered with humanity. Your Winthrop House, and as you can see, there's if you thought winter was still here, there's an awful lot of flowers in bloom. There's tomatoes over there on the pot over there. Don't be envious of Doug, caretaker, that he told me he bought them that way. I guess hothouse prepared, or so he's not that far ahead of everybody. We also have a very, very lovely herb garden here that I'm not about to get into telling you what is there, except that there's 20, 25 different varieties, and you name it, and it's in there. It also is all related to the period of the Deane Winthrop House, and as everybody who knows their herbs knows, that that was originally the first drugstore. There's cures for, I guess, everything in there. It worked today as far as the weather is concerned because it's beautiful. We have a little another flower pot over here and a vegetable garden growing. And this also is our flagpole with our flag. And as you can see, the tables are lined up all over here. Almost like wagon trains have circled the entire yard, and soon they will be filled with laughter and hungry folks eating delicious strawberry shortcake. As always, we're thankful for WCAT for making their annual appearance down here. I guess people would ask, why do you cover the same things year after year after year? Well, there are new faces each year, and people enjoy seeing it, and see one of the advantages of coming to something like this here is to see folks that you haven't seen in a year, or you haven't seen in maybe 5 years, but you'll see different folks that you haven't seen in a while, and they're all town folks, and they're all in a good mood, and they're enjoying themselves.
Thank you. Reardon, he's the president of the Winthrop Improvement and Historical Association, and I'm Linda Costantino. And this is our 94th annual Strawberry Festival, consecutive Strawberry Festival. We're on the grounds of the Deane Winthrop House, and it's just really beautiful this year. We've had a beautiful evening, and lots of people are coming. We've got nice strawberry shortcake, lemonade, and coffee, and a tour of the historic 1637 Deane Winthrop House. The grounds are beautifully landscaped. We have an antique herb garden, and it's just a beautiful time. It's a beautiful event, and we hope every year that people will come down to start their summer with us.
And actually, I've had a pretty relatively easy time of it because I succeeded Linda, who was president for the 2 years before me, and she laid all this groundwork, reshingled the house and the siding. And speaking of siding, our barn is been restained and painted, and it looks pretty sharp.
It looks beautiful.
Yeah,
yes.
really
House and
does.
The Grounds Committee has done a wonderful job this year in restoring and maintaining the property. It's really a lovely place to visit, and we should be very proud. The whole town of Winthrop should be very proud of this property.
Yeah, and you know, Linda, I've been telling people for years, the yard down here, I feel, is the best kept secret in Winthrop.
Absolutely.
That it really is gorgeous, and it's so serene, and you get a beautiful weather day and a nice breeze like we're having today, and you'd just be hard pressed to find a place as nice as it around here.
It's big. It's probably the largest privately owned backyard.
Yeah, it is.
At this point.
Yeah, and as Ian earlier had taken a scan around the yard prior to everybody coming here this evening, and she took in the herb garden, which I refused to tell her anything about the herbs, except that there was about 25 or 30. Yeah. Could you give us some names?
Let me see. We have one called Digitalis. We have medicinal herbs. Digitalis is a heart medication, but is in the herb garden. We have catnip, which is obvious. We have an herb that I can't think of the name of it, but it protects you against moths. It protects your woolen clothing. And then we have many cooking herbs. And many of them are the actual herbs that were used by colonial settlers.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a nice addition to the yard.
And also a plug for the herb garden at our holiday open house. Is it then? We usually have
we do some
herbs that are for sale that
if we're
as
lucky,
you're cleaning
we have,
up the
we, yes, we have some dried herbs that we sell at the open house in December if we're lucky enough to have a good crop.
And Linda, and who else is in your crew that works very diligently on the herb garden?
Let me see. Well, it's mostly Marge Dimes and Claire Roop and several members of the Winthrop Beautification Committee have helped me in the herb garden, including my husband, Frank.
Mm-hmm. And it shows. It's absolutely gorgeous.
Real cream. How are the strawberries?
Ooh, everything is super.
Yeah, someone said they had peaches.
Not the kind of cream that comes out of a spray can.
Oh, it's real cream. That's great.
It's really the real thing all the way.
Someone tell me.
My husband already.
You're all done already. Must be getting ready to go back for seconds.
Buy another ticket.
And maybe a ticket entitles you to seconds. I don't know.
No, you have a ways to go yet.
Jenny Plant.
My name's Jenny Plant. What's that costume now? You're supposed to be just a farm girl?
Puritan girl.
Puritan girl. What's that animal you have in your hand there?
A dog.
A dog. Does it have a name?
Not yet.
Have you had any strawberries yet?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, are they good?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sorry. Do you like strawberries?
Mm-hmm.
Do they have anything else there besides strawberries? Someone said they had peaches.
Yes.
No, you didn't see any of those, huh? You gonna be here all afternoon?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, any other family members here?
Yeah, my mother.
Your mother's here, okay. Is she dressed up like you too?
No.
Oh, okay, just you. Okay, we'll talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
These kids. kids look like they're having a good time anyway. Let's introduce them again. Who is it? Aubrey Gray?
Mm-hmm.
Who's Aubrey?
Me.
And Shannon Gray? And you've already been inside the Deane Winthrop House? Oh, with the field trip. Now, what'd you think of it?
What was Deane Winthrop?
I have to confess that I don't know.
Do you know Shannon from the...
Own quite a bit of property in the community.
I didn't realize how much land there was with these two buildings.
You don't see yards very much, very big in Winthrop, so this is quite a big size.
Very nice.
Quite a big lot, yeah. But so this is your first year here, huh? That's pretty interesting.
Yeah.
Plan to coming back again?
Sure do.
How were the strawberries? They all gone?
No, there's plenty.
There's plenty up there, but you finished yours. They're pretty good, huh?
Delicious.
That's good.
Whipped cream is a real treat, though. Real whipped cream.
That's what everyone's saying. Interesting.
Oh, I could hide 'neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings. And we rise, wipe the sleep out of our eyes. Your shaven razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Now you know how happy we can be. Oh, and our good times started then, with a dollar one to spend. But how much, baby, do we really need? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Again, I want you to stay next time. Though sometimes this world ain't kind, when people get lost like you and me. I just made some friends. Friend is someone you need. But now that we have to go away, I still hear the words that he might say. Turn on your heart light, let it shine wherever you go. Just let it make a happy glow for all the world to see. Turn on your heart light in the middle. young boy's dream. Don't wake me up too soon. We gonna take a ride across the moon, you and me. He's looking for home.
I want everyone to introduce themselves. Who's right there?
I'm Elsie Palermo.
Elsie Palermo.
Very happy to be here. Doherty.
Doherty. What's your first name?
Olga.
Olga Doherty. Who's this gentleman?
Steve Hagan.
Steve Hagan.
We're all from the Revere Society for Cultural and Historic Preservation, and we're learning some tips.
We're going to have a strawberry thing too.
We're restoring an old Greek Revival house in Revere.
You're saying it's such a success.
Wow. How did you like it? How was the strawberry?
We haven't been inside yet, but we really enjoyed it.
Beautiful.
This is great.
That's good, yeah.
And St. Deane Winthrop is buried in Revere.
We have one.
Tell them about our building.
Yeah, we have a Greek Revival building that was built in 1900. It was a former Immaculate Conception Church rectory. And for the last 3.5 years, we've been in the process of trying to restore it so it'll be a cultural center for artifacts from the history of Revere, Revere Beach, but Revere in general. Yeah, the building is on the Massachusetts Register of Historic Places, and we're thinking of trying to have an event like this.
Now, what did you say about Deane Winthrop being buried in Revere?
We understand Deane Winthrop is buried in Revere.
Yeah, nice.
So, we want to may exhume him and have him buried in
No, we don't want that to happen.
Can you substantiate that?
Pardon? That he's buried there?
Sure. It's got to be.
Whereabouts, Ann?
At Rumley Marsh.
Rumley Marsh.
Cemetery.
Near Butler Street. Right off Butler Street. Yeah.
Where is it again?
Rumney Marsh Burying Ground off Butler Street in Revere. Yeah. So we're trying to bring, you know, the same sort of a thing to Revere and have a place for people to present, you know, cultural activities, art exhibits, and so on. Because unfortunately, Revere artists, whether they be musical artists or painters, they have no place to do anything like that, no place to show their things. And we want to have like a meeting place for things like that. And
And the new our center, 108 Beach Street, near the Immaculate Conception Church, right in our parish.
Diagonally across, yeah.
Okay. $250,000 we're raising. It's beautiful. You're invited to come to see it. When we have an open house, we'll send a invitation.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. They have, what, two-thirds of the outside?
Two-thirds of the outside. Of
right.
The,
two-thirds of the outside.
And we
they put in a ramp for right. The
disabled. We have a beautiful people. Ramp that just went in.
And they're putting in a bathroom for handicapped people. A bathroom that could be used by the people in wheelchairs.
How long have you been doing this?
About 3 years.
I wish you a lot of luck.
About 3 years, yeah. It's been a tough job.
Private funds only.
Yeah.
And we did the centennial down Revere Beach, the 100-year centennial. We had the,
we had a pavilion with
a pavilion. The historic pavilion. We did
Peter McCauley's pictures of the beach and Norman Gutrow's pictures of
the
beach.
So we're bringing dignity and culture to the city.
Mm-hmm.
I just called to say
hello.
I couldn't sleep at all tonight, and I know it's late, I just couldn't wait. Hello, my friends, hello. I just called to let you know I think about you
Lately it's been crazy. Maybe I have to play. Won't you put your heart above your head?
Give us a wave. Give us a wave over there.
We've been through it all, and you love me just the same. And when you're not there, I still need to hear. Hello, again, hello. It's good to need you so.
What are your names? What's your name?
Her name is Rita.
Who?
Rita. Rita Bryan.
What's Breon. Your name? What's your name?
Lyra Marola.
Marola. How long have you been coming to the Strawberry Festival?
This is the third season for us.
Third season, huh? Is it just as good as in the past, or is it better this year, or about the same?
I think it's good.
Yeah.
I think the servings are more generous this year.
Oh,
I have
really?
To say that. Getting a little more this year.
That's good. Maybe they had a better crop of strawberries. You didn't get the biscuit, just the strawberries, huh?
Just the strawberries.
Okay, yeah.
Why don't you like the biscuit?
I don't like them. I don't like them.
Those are quite the flowers behind you. They're very nice.
Aren't they pretty?
Yeah. What kind are they?
Good. Who knows?
I think they're my mom.
Some kind of a mom.
What are they called? They're a mom, y'all.
Right, yeah.
I'm not going to eat while she's got that camera on.
I'll put it over here. So.
Your turn.
Kylie's.
Okay.
Little Gallagher.
Say hello.
Hello.
Amy, who's this one right here?
This is James and Mark, their brothers and their aunts, Kathy and
Kathy. Hi.
Hi. Mark, you want to see on TV? Mark, you going to be on TV?
Hi, honey.
Right here.
Where is he?
Mark, right here.
Mark. Hey, Mark, look up here.
Mark, look at Mark.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Yes.
Hi, Bob, how are you?
Did you get anything to eat? I'm coming.
Thank you.
long have you been there?
She wants to know your name.
Oh, my name is Mabel Woodcock, and I'm a friend of Sue's. I don't know why, but anyway, she puts up with me.
How many years have you been coming?
Couple. Oh, you answer.
My name is Sue Gray, and I belong to the Historical Society. And I've been here a few years, but I have to be honest, I don't help as much as I should because it's nice to sit and relax. This is Carolyn over here.
You're close to me.
I'm too close to you.
Over there.
No. All right, Carolyn was too close. This is Pat.
Hi, Pat Lawrence, and I just love the food and the company as well. And I'm a member of the I hope I am.
Yes.
I better check my dues.
I know this is a talking group.
All right, next one, Carol.
Hi, I'm Jane Chevalier. I'm also a member. Now I'm going to pass it over to my sister real quick.
I'm still because the light from the sun is right in my eyes. My name is Carolyn Nickerson. I'm a member of Historical and the Winthrop Playmakers and Rebecca Lodge. And I sing at the Methodist Church. They will be having some summer evenings with a comedy, a swing dance demonstration. Gosh, I can't remember all of them, but there's going to be like every 3 weeks during the summer, there's going to be a presentation in the downstairs theater. No, not this year. There may be productions with some children in it, but they won't be children's productions per se. No. Okay? Thank you.